Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. The tips today and this week are from a book called Guerilla Data Analysis Using Microsoft Excel, the very first book that I wrote. Jim sent in this question. He says, hey, I have two worksheets with differing information on both worksheets, but there's one field that ties them together. Now, in Jim's case, it was a serial number. The data I have here, they're tied together by customer name. So, on my first worksheet, the forecast worksheet, you see I have customers and forecast. I'm going to go into the next worksheet, so that's control page down, and you see that I have customers and orders. And just like Jim said, he says some serial numbers are on one sheet, some serial numbers are on the other sheet, and many serial numbers are on both sheets. Is there some automated way that I can match those up? Automated? No. There's several ways to do this that we're going to talk about this week. And the first method I'm going to use is what I call the double lookup method. So we're going to come here to the second list. Actually, I'm going to take this second list and I'm going to copy it onto the first worksheet so they're kind of side by side. We can see what's happening here. So, I'm going to go to the second list. I'm going to add a new column at the end. It's called there, the there column, as in, is it there? And here I can either do a VLOOKUP or a match. I'll do a match just to illustrate the match. I want to look for this customer, AT&T, within this list over here, A2 to A21. Press the F4 key to put the dollar signs in. At the end of match, we have to put either 0 or false. I'm going to put a 0. And that's saying we're looking for an exact match. Copy that down by double clicking the fill handle. Now, the match returns what row it's on, which isn't the most useful thing in the whole world. But what I really care about are the NAs. I want to get all of those NAs together. That NA is saying this item is not in the first list. And I'm trying to build a superset of the two lists. So if I sort this data by the there field, all of the NAs will come to the bottom. I'm going to take those NAs. I'm going to copy the customer names and paste them to the bottom of the first list, and then come over to the forecast field and fill those in with zeros. So, I'll enter a zero there, double click the fill handle to copy it down, and basically we're saying, hey, these customers didn't have a forecast. All right, so that's the first lookup. The first lookup's done. The second lookup now is to go back and get the orders. We're going to do a VLOOKUP there, equal VLOOKUP. Look up AIG within this list. Press F4 again. I want the second field, comma 2, comma false, and copy that down. All right, and what we're going to see is that for all the records that were in common, for example, AT&T, forecast of 1.38 million, order of 1.37 million. Now we still have the problem with the NAs over here. So one more sort, sort and filter. Z to A, and I can override all of those NAs with a 0, and then sort again by customer. I now have married these two lists up. I can see which customers had a forecast and orders, which had only a forecast, and which had orders. Now, again, this is the what I call the double lookup method. You do one lookup in the second list to figure out which items from the second list are not in the first list. Add them to the first list and then do your real lookup to bring the data over. Tomorrow, we'll take a look at a different way to do this, a way using pivot tables, which you might find to be a little bit easier and faster. So, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.